What needs to be done further in terms of biopharmaceuticals, in terms of application of biotechnology into agriculture, in terms of number of other industries, and this is what we need to showcase further as to what we can do in terms of biotech and pharma. Textiles and leather, again, textiles, apparel, these are all have been there in Karnataka for a long time. We were known as silk, wool, and cotton center, and talented and skilled workforce continues to be here. We are looking at a lot of new initiatives in terms of technical textiles required for the aerospace industry and a number of other integrated textile units. And in terms of apparel, a very large employer of people. So that's again another initiative which has been taken up. And likewise in leather side also, a lot of new initiatives need to be taken up. More will be discussed in the session. Agribusiness and food processing. We all know that Karnataka has been the major source. We know that ITC and a number of Nestle and a number of other companies thrive here. We need to see how we can move up the value chain and address to the growing needs for the consumers. And for this, we encourage the investments in a number of these subsectors. In terms of electrical and electronics, Elecrama, which is the leading fair for electrical electronics industry, is held here on a biannual basis. And electronics industry, great volume of that is here, but we need to work on further in terms of automotive electronics, in terms of defense electronics, and in terms of a number of other fields, chip design activities and others. And we will discuss it further in our sessions. Startups, Karnataka has been the center for startups, having seen more than 4,000 startups originating here. And the government is working very strongly with the startup ecosystem for encouraging more and more incubators, accelerators, and seeing how more and more of these startups can be supported, and in terms of mentoring, in terms of finance, and a lot of initiatives which are being taken up. We were the first ones with a startup policy, which came up even before the startup action plan from Government of India. In terms of plastics and chemicals, again, there are a lot of opportunities, and we are working closely with CPET to set up a research and development institution here. And with petrochemicals on the coastal side, again, these are some of the focus sectors that we are going to concentrate in this two-day conference. In terms of government support, infrastructure, policy framework, and facilitation, Karnataka has been promoting public-private partnership in terms of infrastructure. And we were the first ones to have our airport. The airport in Karnataka is a shining example of what is public-private partnership. And likewise, other ventures have been taken up in railways, in highways, and other sectors. And we are looking at seaport development as well. Beside this energy side, a lot of investments are likely to be there. And we have very open solar power policy, wind energy, and other renewable energies sectors as well. Policies, Karnataka has industrial policy and sector policies on various sector focuses. And we encourage industry dispersal to take place beyond Bangalore to the hinterland also. And I'm happy to mention that most of the industries, manufacturing industries that are coming up not in Bangalore, but outside of Bangalore. And we encourage this in terms of our industrial policy, which is, as Honorable Minister, Chief Minister mentioned, is very, very progressive. In terms of facilitation, we have Karnataka Udyog Mitra, which is the facilitation agency. We have also encouraging lot and lot of activities to flow online. And Invest Karnataka is a new company, which is a unique experiment in terms of government of Karnataka and the industry working together as a single unified company to promote investments in Karnataka. We have a single portal for all information, ebizkarnataka.gov.in. With this, I'll conclude. Thank you, and wish a very fruitful deliberations in the days to come. Thank you.